Okay, let's cover the basics of Google Plus and your Google Plus profile. First, here I am on the homepage. Community invitations, upcoming events, it's recommending people that you might know to add to circles. Basically, people who are in my circles and people that I follow are the activities that I'm seeing here. So this is something you can control, and I'll show you that in another video. But let's start with making a post. I've covered this in another video, but the basics of covering a post is if you have asterisks, you can have a title. So here I could, put my headline. And once I put a headline here, I could write paragraphs of text. This is not like Facebook, where it's basically a picture with a little bit of text. I could add photos, I could add a video, and I could add links to websites. Now here it's recommending the people that I invited the last one, but this is really important. I could invite the public. If I invite the public, it's basically like a blog post. I published it and there it is, open to the public. I could invite public, but I could also go down here into my many circles that I have. These are different courses that I have, different clients that I have in these different courses, and I could invite them. Okay, all the ones that you see here with these little circles connected, these are circles. Okay, so this is one of my courses where this is just an open circle of people that I believe are interested in one of my courses. These aren't the clients. But if I go down here, this is the same course, but these are people who enrolled in this course in a specific version that I have for multi-level marketing. And then so here I could select the people that I want. Now if I go further down, these are communities. So here it's telling me, here's a community, where do I want to publish it? Now here's the thing, it's telling me that I can't invite circles and communities at the same time. So this is something that you need to decide ahead of time. Now circles are very flexible, here's public and here's the different circles. And again, if I'm only gonna send this to clients, like in this case, this is almost like sending a newsletter. I could put a video here with some text and I could send the newsletter out to just these clients. If I have a community, like Law of Attraction for Business, here it's telling me where do I wanna publish it, I could put it in general discussions. Now I'm gonna send this post out to the community. Now notice, I'm not in the community, I'm in the homepage. But I could do this. This will go out to the whole community. Now, one thing interesting, let me go back to some circles here. If I invite a few different circles, and I'm about to post this, look what it says here. It says, also send emails to these three circles. Now, there's a limit. I'm not sure what it is, but sometimes if I put too many circles with too many people, it says you can't send a broadcast to that many people. But I delete a few and it lets me. So I don't know what the number is. I should research that. But this is kind of cool. This is like a free autoresponder sending out emails. So the process of creating these circles is a little bit manual. And let me get into that now. I'm going to cancel this because I'm not going to publish it. But basically, when you're in a community, it's real easy, like the Law of Attraction for Business. You could see what people are posting. You could say, hey, wow, that person's a coach like me. And you might put that in a strategic alliances circle. You decide. No one sees the name of the circle that you're adding them to, but they do get a message saying so-and-so added you to a circle. And typically that should be a message. If someone adds you to a circle, add them back. if you could put them in a decent category. Okay, so that's the basics of how to use Google Plus. I'm telling you that if you treat this like the blog of the past, if you do several posts a week, and you target it to your community, to the people who you're following, or the people who should be following you, your ideal client that you're trying to manifest, this could be very powerful. Another thing very important in Google Plus is search for people. Here, if you go into the people segment here on the profile, you could search for different people, you could search for different communities. There's many ways you could find various folks. And you could start and maybe search for the leaders in your industry. Start following them. And the secret to this is when you follow somebody, in if there's a leader in your community or somebody that is well respected in your community, follow them and engage on their pages. Don't start, putting links back to your page right away. Engage with them. Ask questions. Comment on it. Share their links. See who else is engaging in those pages. So This is really important. Look, here you could search for coworkers, a lot of different tools that it gives you, but also here, go to communities, and you can create a community or you could search for a community. So communities are probably the best places that you can create circles that are very strategic to you. Search for communities in your market, you know, join them. A lot of them are public, some of them are private, you can't, but you could request to be added. But search for communities and see which ones are the most active, the people who are interacting, engaging, and that's a great way for you to build out your circles. Okay, lastly, let me end with this. As far as your profile is concerned, you know, I'm in the internet marketing world and lifestyle is a big thing here. So the fact that I've been traveling for 4 years and all over Latin America, I'm using that. My next step, I'm looking to build a company again. I want to build a bigger company, an asset. So maybe this will change. Okay, but obviously the picture that you choose and everything needs to reflect that. But here, when you go to the about, and you go to edit this, which you could do right here to edit, look at all the real estate that it gives you in your story. Okay, your tagline, your introduction, there's different techniques here. I like to use the hero's journey as one of my formulas. You know, we'll talk about this in the live event, but a hero's journey basically starts off at a high point. You know, hey, I've been traveling, you know, I love waking up in the morning and hearing the sounds or seeing the beach. It's so inspiring to take a walk at 7 a.m. and dive in the ocean and come back and get to work. But it wasn't always like this. You start off where your ideal client wants to be, then you go back and say, hey, but it wasn't always like this, and you go to where they are. And then from there you say, but then I found this mentor and I started taking steps forward, and the hero's journey is very hypnotic. And really you're talking about them, although you're talking about yourself. You're selecting the stories in your life that you're using to attract your ideal client. Very, very powerful. But the main point here is, look at all the real estate it gives you. Here I go, you know, themes and interests of mine. This is all in Spanish, but I'm pulling bullets, and these bullets are the taglines, the keyword phrases that I'm looking for. So when people search for business over the internet, I have a good chance of coming up. And again, this is all using Google's powerful search engine technology. So definitely take advantage of this. Write something that's interesting, that's captivating, not all just about yourself and the big lots of dots showing all the different degrees you got. That's all fine. Put it at the bottom. But try to write something that's engaging, that people can really, you know, have a sense of curiosity or adventure or leadership that you could reflect here. Okay. And there's a lot of things that it does for you. Look, it's tracking all the places I've been traveling in the last couple of years. And look, links. So here's where you can take advantage of this. This is my profile. This is my YouTube channel. Here are my main links of the websites that I manage, other profiles. So this is all really powerful. Take advantage of the Google Plus profile. It is very, very strong. Okay, we'll continue in the next video.